Let's turn it quick enough.
Hello everyone, my name is Caleb Guerrero, and today I'll be showcasing you part two of my capstone project presentation. Beginning of this capstone project, I decided to dabble into the hip-hop production. Ever since I took computer music courses at Ball State University, I decided that I wanted to really compose beats and dabble into the hip-hop production. And so for the capstone project, I decided to make a total of 8 beats over the course of several weeks up until today. And for module 2, I will be presenting 3 beats that I've created in the past 4 weeks. And after each bit of sampling, I will explain briefly. So this first beat, we'll play a snippet of a song called Schroeder. Decided to not use as many samples, especially as a crutch. And for this one, I wanted to try playing a little bit of the piano ballad as an intro, and then use just a downward chord progression as my loop sample for the remainder of the track. So moving on, beat 7. For this beat in particular, I wanted to focus on a more niche subgenre of hip hop known as shell hop, or some people prefer to call it lo-fi. And the only samples I used for this one were FM radio changing static and raindrops. And just to add the white noise in the background and have a nice, smooth bass in, just for a calming experience. And lastly, my tenor. For this one, I decided to try something that has much more of a drive than we're used to, using other software instruments and low sampling. Well, actually, one sample, and that was with sampling a MIDI sound from a drum kit and making another sampler to do a reverse effect at the beginning of the track. Now, alongside of making these beats, I decided to start looking into what it takes to be a producer and where one would publish their beats. And I found 3 sites known for being standard places for production and making connections. One of them known as iStandardProducer.com, which provides direct links to A&Rs. While having the middleman right there upon registration, you'll be able to send them emails. Beatstars.com is known for being more community focused and artist driven with remix contests and artist contact, where you would be working with the artists when participating in them, and musicdealers.com, which is more commercial based, where you'll be able to have contacts upon registration with music supervisors and TV and commercial campaigns. And with having the list of sites to publish beats in future endeavors, I'll be moving into the process where you can start and what the cost would be in the final presentation. Any questions?
How many beat publishers are out there?
So from what I've seen, there were over 20 sites, although some would allow you to have rights up